Hi, I'm Tracy from Profit Business Group. Today we're going to talk about how user acceptance testing can make your Dynamics GP launch go a lot more smoothly. No one wants to spend hundreds of hours and thousands of dollars implementing a system only to have the users not use it at the end. So instead of just hoping that your users are going to adopt the system, user acceptance testing is essential for not only ensuring that you've met their requirements, but for also getting them involved and engaged in the process. So here's how you do a successful user acceptance test. Users need at least basic training on how to use the system before they do their user acceptance test. This is so that they can get through the processes without you having to provide a super detailed click-by-click explanation in order for them to get through their processes. Number two is you want to give each user exactly a detailed testing script of what they need to test. If you just give them a carte blanche, go and test the system, they won't. So what you need to do is to outline in detail the processes that they use every day and have them mark off each of the items that they successfully test to verify that each function works. Number three is what they're going to test. So you want them to do a realistic test of their everyday transactions. If the person does sales orders or purchase orders, have them grab a stack of the ones that they did last week and have them try and replicate that in the new system. Take their last week's payroll, run it through, see if the calculations match. If they do importing, have them actually run one of those files that they ran last week, make sure that it populates into Dynamics GP and gives them the result that they expect. And finally, users need support during the whole process of user acceptance testing. It is a brand new system to them, and you're trying to test the system and that it works. You're not trying to test the user's knowledge of it. You don't want them to get into a space where they get stuck and they get frustrated and say the system doesn't work. Help them along through the process, and they can see and verify that the function that they need actually works, and then you both have something worth celebrating. Are you looking for some more advice on how to do a great user acceptance test? Come talk to us at Profit or read the blog post that is on our website.